Finally, Bill Clinton just shows America his penis. The San Diego Zoo displays the first rhino stillborn in captivity, and a woman is dumped on her 15-week anniversary. One day, some twisted son of a bitch is bound to teach you a thing or two about living in this cold, godforsaken world. But for now, this is the Onion Week in Review, saying this is the greatest advance in smartphone technology since the iPhone 4S. Apple announced today the release of the brand new, highly anticipated iPhone 4SE. Just 11 months after unveiling the last edition of the popular smartphone, CEO Tim Cook took the stage to smatterings of applause to present the 4SE's new features, including an enhanced Siri voice search, upgraded talk and type technology, and updates to Apple's iCloud software.
The 4SE is the one everyone's been waiting for. It has an advanced version of our iOS format, and believe it or not, we've upgraded the camera 2 full megapixels. This thing is the future.
According to sources along I-85, Vice President Joe Biden was seen hitchhiking to the Democratic National Convention this week, relying solely on his charm and the generosity of passing motorists to make the 400-mile journey between Washington, D.C. and Charlotte, North Carolina. Eyewitness reports confirmed the 69-year-old vice president rode in at least 11 separate vehicles, telling drivers he'd get to the convention whenever the hell he got there.
I dropped him off at a truck stop near Chester about 2 nights ago. Said he planned on sleeping there. Told me all a man needs to sleep is a bench to lie on and a cold one to nurse him to bed. I said it might be a little dangerous out there alone. He said he was carrying his butterfly knife and that he just got his green belt in Taekwondo.
Members of the Supreme Court said today that their newly hired agent, Rory McCleft, is already getting them better cases. Despite being hired only 3 months ago, McCleft has already booked the Supreme Court high-profile cases such as Hill versus the United States and the National Federation of Independent Business versus Sebelius, both of which, members of the court agree, would have never happened under former agent Jeff Muslim.
So I talked to the Supreme Court, asked them where they saw themselves in 5 years. They all agreed. They wanted to make it to the big time, and that means getting them out of all that gun control stuff they've been doing lately and into some really great cases. Hold on, I gotta take this. Hey, Sotomayor, my favorite justice. How you doing?
According to sources, all 4 members of New York-based improvisational troupe Calhoun are balding.
We here at Mike's Petroleum Sandwiches, we value our customers.
Reports indicate that the bald and out-of-shape men, all of whom are currently in their mid to late 30s and haven't held a single job paying more than $45,000 a year, have devoted their lives to improv despite never once having received any compensation for their work.
When people ask what it is we do, I tell them it's a mixture between really silly and really smart. Like that scene we did where Abraham Lincoln was a freshman in college. Why the fuck is Anne Frank there? I actually just talked to a manager who's pretty into our stuff. He hasn't called back yet, but I think it'll be a big step for us.
In other news, the creator of Breaking Bad thinks maybe next season should take a dark turn. An area man crawls on the ground like a pig to plug his MacBook Pro power cord behind his desk, and Prince Charles thinks the boys are finally old enough to find out what happened to their mother. Now that the video is over, here's a tip about this hellish world. Never fall in love. She'll rip your heart out and leave you for dead. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.